Today we are gonna find out whether the method of undervolting is irrelevant, or if one of these two provides better performance. This is the result of the standard method, a curve lower than the stock one, with a spike corresponding to your desired voltage and frequency point. In my case, 1744 millivolts and 1590 MHz. How to achieve it? Just select all the points, click on the highest one and drag them down to your target frequency. Then select the point coinciding with your target voltage, drag it up to that same frequency, and click Apply. As you can see, the shape here in the VF curve editor is different from the actual one. Now, this is the result of my own method. A curve that follows the stock one up to a certain point, where the frequency starts to linearly increase until it reaches your desired voltage, and finally flatlines a couple of steps lower. So, how to attain it? Simply watch my year-old series, linked above. Yes, it may be longer than necessary, but I'm still very proud of it. After all, it was my launch content. And as can be seen, the two curves overlap now. Anyway, I tested each of these two methods 10 times in Unigine superposition 4K. Note that even though I set 1590 MHz as my target frequency, this drops by one step as soon as the core temperature rises to 38 degrees. If you want more information about this normal variation in frequency as a function of temperature, you will find it in the 5th episode of my aforementioned series. Bearing that in mind, here are the results in full form. But let's focus on the average scores. There's a clear difference between them, albeit small. What's this due to? As you may notice, even though the nominal frequency is equal with both methods, the effective frequency is lower with the former. In fact, while the average effective clock is 1568 MHz with the popular spike approach, it's 1572 MHz with my curve one. However, if that difference in mean scores were not statistically significant, it would make no sense whatsoever to choose my modus operandi over the other. Hence, to find out the truth, I compared those means via my dependent t-test script in RStudio, which output the following data. Since the resulting p-value is less than or equal to 0.01, the statistical significance is confirmed. In simpler terms, I've proven that my method of undervolting performs better than the prevailing one. But does this conclusion hold true, even when going from my maximum to my minimum UV profile? Well, with a nominal frequency of 1905 MHz at 900 mV, the difference in effective clock between the two approaches is even greater. It's 20 MHz. Because this will be 100% reflected in the mean scores, the ultimate conclusion is obvious. My own process remains better. So the choice is now yours. If you prefer a method that's less performant but faster to implement, pick the rough spike, by all means. Instead, if you fancy a method that's more performant but slower to implement, pick my refined curve. It's a classic case of Mario versus Luigi. To me, Luigi always wins. Thanks for tuning in and farewell for now.